The World Cup is finally here. At the time of uploading this video, 4 o'clock on Thursday, the first game is going ahead. Russia versus Saudi Arabia. Let me know in the comments who do you think is going to win. And if the game has already happened, guys, don't comment because you already know the score. Right now, from me, it is Thursday. I have no idea what any of the scores are for Thursday night matches. But I am all hoping that England win the World Cup. It's looking unlikely. For me personally, I'm going to go out and say it. I think it's between three teams. I think Brazil, France, or Germany. They're my three favourites for winning the World Cup. However, we're going to be using the FIFA World Cup predictor made by EA Sports to go ahead and predict the entirety of the World Cup. I've never done anything like this. I didn't even predict the Premier League. I'm not a huge fan of predicting stuff, but nonetheless, we're going to go into it and predict the World Cup 2018 in Russia. But before we do start, guys, make sure you are subscribed. Click a like if you enjoyed this video. And also, let me know in the comments, who do you think is going to win the World Cup? I want to hear your opinions, and I'm going to be replying to most of your comments. So make sure you let me know in the comments, who do you think is going to win the World Cup? But let's get into it. All right, Group A, who is going to qualify? Now, for me, this one is pretty easy. Okay, I think Uruguay, you're going to go through. And Egypt, yes, they have Mo Salah, but do they have a strong squad if you compare it to Russia? Russia are the hosts. They have the host backing. They're going to have the support. For me, Russia, Uruguay are going to go through. Okay, next up, we've got Group B. Iran, Morocco, Spain and Portugal. Spain, obviously, have just appointed a new manager. So they may be a little bit on the rocky road type of thing at the moment. However, saying that, Ronaldo's Portugal and Spain, for me, are the two favourites for this. Morocco and Iran, I just don't think they can do it against the mighty Portugal and Spain. Group C. Now, this is going to be an easy one. Oh, I don't know. Easy one for me. Yes, France. Favourites for the group, obviously. Australia, Peru and Denmark. Denmark, standout player. Eriksen. Australia. I've been to Australia recently this year. They have a good squad. But for me, I'm going to go... Well, this is a tough one. You know, I don't know too much about Peru either. So for me, I think... You know what? You know what, boys and girls? I'm going to go for Denmark. Let me know in the comments, what do you think for this one? Do you think Peru are going to go in? Do you think Australia are going to go in? For me, it's going to be France topping the group without a shadow of a doubt. But I'm going to go with Denmark second. Ooh, first and second. Okay, I need to make sure I do first and second right. I think I might have done it wrong in the last one. Argentina, Messi, you've got to qualify. Nigeria have a very good squad this year. Very good squad. The likes of Iwobi as well. Croatia, again, Modric, Kovacic? Who's the guy that plays for Real Madrid? It's Kovacic. Okay, I'm going to give up on that one. You know what? I'm going to go for an outside hope. No, I was going to go for Nigeria. Iceland, obviously, you know what they did in the Euros. They were the driving force of the Vikings. But for me, I'm going to go Croatia second. I do think Nigeria have an outside hope, but Croatia just have a too good squad, in my opinion. Now, for me, Group E have the favourites. All right, Brazil. I'm backing Brazil. I know I said it's between about three teams, but I'm going to go for Brazil. All right, I think Brazil, their squad at the moment is one of the best squads they've had in a while. All right, I think it's their best squad since the 2002 team of Ronaldinho, Ronaldo, Rivaldo, Adriano, Roberto Carlos, Cafu, Dida. It was unbelievable. So for me, Brazil are going to qualify first in their group. Costa Rica, Serbia, or Switzerland. You know what? I'm actually going to go, I think, Costa Rica. Every year, they seem to do okay in the group, don't they? They don't do too bad. Serbia do have a good side, but I think I'm going to give Costa Rica an outside chance here. I'm going to go a little bit crazy. It might be wrong. It might be proved to be wrong, but you know what? I'm going to give Costa Rica a go. All right, Germany, Mexico, Sweden, or South Korea. Germany, favourites. Again, they are in the top three. I said Brazil, France, or Germany. Mexico. Did you know Mexico have Rafael Marquez? He used to play for Barcelona. This is his fifth World Cup. 2018, 2014, 2010, 2006, and 2002. Okay, I think that's a joint record for the most World Cups. Don't quote me on that. But I'm going to go with Sweden. I'm going to go with Sweden, guys. Is Zlatan still playing? I'm pretty sure he's still playing. I don't think he's retired by now. But I'm going to go Germany first, Sweden second. But Mexico do have a good squad at the moment. They do have a very good squad. All right, Group G. This is the mighty England. Are we going to come out on top, though? That is the question. Or are Belgium going to come out on top? Belgium have a bloody good squad, I got to tell you. But they don't perform at World Cups or Euros, do they? They have a good squad, but they never seem to perform. So, I think that Panama and Tunisia they're out, all right? It's between Belgium and England. Who's going to come top of our group, boys and girls? Is it going to be Belgium? Is it going to be Harry Kane's England? Is he going to leave the line? Is he going to get the goals? You know what? I've got to do it. I've got to do it. I'm not a true patriot. I'm not a true England fan if I don't say we're going to top the group. I'm going to put Belgium second. It might be stupid of me putting England. You know, our performances at World Cups aren't great. We usually go up to the quarterfinals to Portugal by some red card or some dodgy Ronaldo. But I'm going to put England first, Belgium second. Group H, Poland, Senegal, Colombia and Japan. Colombia, for me, they're going to top the group. Now, I recently went to Japan, all right, and the video is actually coming out very soon. So you'll be looking forward to that. I learned a lot about Japanese football, okay? They style their football on Brazil. So they're not the biggest people, they're not the strongest people, not the most physical people out there. But technically, Japan are unbelievable. However, saying that, have you seen Lewandowski's goal scoring record for Poland in these qualifiers in the last international games? It is unbelievable. So, Japan may have a better side, but I think Lewandowski is going to score the goals and do the bits for Poland. So, Colombia first, Poland second. Now into the round of 16. All right, this is a strong side. Okay, so I selected Uruguay versus Spain. Suarez versus Sergio Ramos. I'm going to put Spain to win that one. I have to go out and say it. I think Spain are going to win. I know they've had a rocky road with the change of manager, but their squad isn't changing. France versus Croatia. I'm going to put France. Mbappe, you're going to do the bits. This could be Mbappe's moment. Can he make it his World Cup? Brazil versus Sweden. Brazil, without a shadow of a doubt, I think. So at the moment, I've got France and Brazil both through. England versus Poland. Oh my God, this could be a tough fight. I'm going to have to back England, you know. Lewandowski, as I said, he's a big boy at the moment. He's doing well, but we've got Harry Kane. We've got Raheem Sterling. I'm going to back us in the round of 16. Let's get us through to the quarterfinals. Come on. Portugal versus Russia. Russia, the host team. Yes, they're going to have the support, but Ronaldo's Portugal. They won the Euros, remember? I'm going to put Portugal. Argentina, Denmark. Lionel Messi versus Christian Eriksen. Who's going to come out on top? I think it's going to be Lionel Messi. And don't forget, Denmark, do they have Bender? I can't remember if he's in the squad. Bender could do wonders for Denmark. However, saying that, Argentina for me. Germany versus Costa Rica. I think that's a no-brainer, Germany. Now, Colombia versus Belgium. Colombia have a very good squad, if you don't know. But Belgium also have a very good squad. This is going to be a tight one. I think this one could go to, like, extra time and pens. But for me, I think Belgium, this is their time to prove themselves as a team, not just a bunch of collective individuals. Going to put the Belgium win for that one. The quarterfinals. Oh my God, this is how I've panned it out. Okay, look at the sides remaining. Spain, France, Brazil, England, Germany, Belgium, Portugal, Argentina. All right, Spain versus France. This is a huge game. Absolute huge game. Neighbours in Europe. Okay, I'm going to go France. Usually I'd say Spain, you know. They've won the World Cup. France haven't recently. Last time France won, it was 1998. Oh, I'm going to go out there and say France. You know, I think they have a really good squad this year. England versus Brazil. I'm sorry. It's the repeat of the 2002 game. Ronaldinho, David Seaman. You know what happened, guys. If you don't, check it out. As much as I want to say England are going to beat Brazil in the quarterfinals. I just don't think we will. I can't see it. I'm going to put Brazil going through against England. It heartbreaks me. It is breaking my heart. But Brazil's side, man, they are looking unbelievable. Oh my God, the third quarter final we've got here. Argentina versus Portugal. Ronaldo versus Messi. Who is going to come out on top? Now, for me, I think Portugal have the better side. Oh, like, as a collective, well-rounded side. Argentina, I don't know too much about their side. I know they have Lionel Messi. They have a great attack. But how good is Argentina's defence? They have Otamendi, of course. Oh, this is a tough one. I'm going to go with Portugal, guys. They won the Euros, man. Argentina, they don't do too well in World Cups. I'm going to go, well, in recent times, that is. Obviously, Maxi Rodriguez scored that wonder goal a while back. But I'm going to go with Portugal. This is a tough one. Guys, let me know in the comments, Portugal or Argentina, Ronaldo or Messi? Go on, I'll open up the question to you guys, Ronaldo or Messi. Let me know in the comments. But for me, I'm going to go for Portugal. Germany versus Belgium. I'm going to go for Germany. Belgium obviously have a very good side. But Germany, they're a driving force. They are the lean, mean scoring machines. All right, we're into the semi-finals. France versus Brazil, Germany versus Portugal. Now, I've got three of my favorite teams in there. I think Oh, mate, what do we do here? Brazil or France? Who is going to win that one? Brazil or France? I'm going to have to back my Brazil. I did say from the beginning they're my favourite. France go out in the semi-final to be a valiant effort. Germany versus Portugal. Who is going to win that one? Germany versus Portugal. Mesut Ozil versus Nani. Who's going to come out on top? I'm going to go for Germany. You know, I think Germany have it this year. I think they can get all the way to the final. So that would mean a Portugal-France third place finish. But for the final, Brazil versus Germany. Who's going to win, guys? Let me know in the comments, who do you think is going to win either between Brazil or Germany in my predicted World Cup? Or you think who is going to win overall? For me, I back Brazil. I think Brazil are going to go all the way this year. Neymar is going to do it for the mighty Brazilians. They're going to beat Germany in the World Cup final. That is my prediction, guys. I'm going to click continue. And there it is. My FIFA World Cup winners are Brazil. We've got Jesus, Marcelo, Neymar, Casemiro, and Willian. Who is going to win the World Cup? For me, as I said, my prediction is Brazil, guys. That is this video all done and dusted. My World Cup predictions. Maybe I'll react to it at the end of the World Cup. But I must add, all right, I'm thoroughly enjoying the build-up to the World Cup. It started, obviously, today. I'm so excited. Give this video a thumbs up if you have enjoyed it. I'm going to be doing weekly World Cup football challenges, guys. Three of the best goals each week, just like I did for the Euros. So make sure you give this video a thumbs up if you're excited for that. Subscribe if you haven't already. And boys and girls, the World Cup is here. I'll see you in another video very soon. Until then, see you next.